Hello everyone. Now we are going to see about HTML forms. That means we are going to generate this kind of window on our web page, or this kind of window on our web page. You might have seen while searching on most of the time on internet, or like if you are going on Facebook, it asks for username and password. So how to create such kind of window that we are going to see now. It's very simple. I'll just run a small code. You will understand that. And then we will see the explanation of it. So this is just a small code for that. I will run it and then I will explain. So I've already saved that. This code. Now I will run it. The name of this file is 10th.html. So I will run that 10th.html. And so here first name and last name. Now we will see how it is working. So you can see over here, these two lines are just to start our code. So these last two lines will be the ending of that tag. Our code is from here to here. Let me zoom it so that you can easily able to see that. So now here you can see the only two rows are there. One is first name, another one is last name. Now what we can enter over here is I can write Amit, last name I can enter Mishra. Likewise. So this code, first name. So the command is input, type is text, whether we are writing number or text something, so that we have to mention over there the type. Then name, what exactly we are writing over here? It indicates some first name. So we have to write over here the first name. Then next line, this last name should appear on the next line. Next line, not in front of this. Therefore, to do that, we have to give this break tag over here. After this break tag, whatever we are writing, that will appear on the next line. So next is last name, input, again it's a text, and name is last name, and again break. So the syntax is form, action, and double inverted comma, and form, close. So this is save. Now I run. So this kind of window will appear. It will take only text, so I have to write down text. If I'm writing one or two, right now it is inactive, so it will accept it. But when we will active this, at that time it won't take number because we have declared it, the type as text. Another way we can understand it, right? Like if I'll write username over here. So I have to mention over here, like it's a user. Name indicate user, and here password, so it will indicate password. Password. So I will save it. So your username and password, whatever I am writing over here, that we are going to see on the window. Now, if I write something over here, both are text type. So say Amit, and if I'm writing password like this, right now it is not hiding it, but to how to hide that we will see in JavaScript. I'm just showing you how to create such kind of window. That's it. This is what HTML is about. So this is one HTML form. Another HTML form is, this is the code for that. Now what is that? I'll show you what output we are going to get through the next HTML form. So this kind of window we are going to generate, this kind of option we are going to generate on the window. Checkbox, we can say basically. So how to do that? I'll show you. This is the code for it. I'll just run this and then we will see. I have already saved that with the file 11th.html. So I will run 11th. See, so it is showing the output over here. We'll just zoom it so that you can see that. Here it's Volvo. Now, if I'll drag it, there are four options over here. Now, how it is working? So, again, we'll start from here. So, form, action, double inverted comma, form close. Now, these option value is equal to Volvo. Volvo option is that tag. So, we have to close this. So, we have closed that. Value Fiat. Fiat option close, option close, option tag close, option value Audi, Audi option close, option value Saab, and Saab close. Now you can see over here, if I'll drag it, the things which are coming is a small alphabet. That means what? Whatever we are writing over here, or here, that will appear on this. These are just the tags. Option, value, Volvo. If I write XYZ, still it will accept. But on the backend code, we should know what we have written, so that user who is using that code next time, he will understand it. Suppose I have written XYZ. Still, if I run it, it will show Volvo only. But sometimes somebody will open it, the code. There, they should understand it properly. So we are writing in the same way, Volvo. Now suppose, right now you can see, by default, it is showing Volvo. It is showing Volvo. Now I want that instead of showing Volvo, it should show Audi by default over here. So to do that, what we can do is, in front of Audi, I will write selected is equal to double inverted comma. I will save it. See, so by default, Audi is coming over here. Now, if I'll drag all four options, I can see, but initially it will show the Audi. This is another thing we can do over here. I hope you have understand that. So these two or three things which we have done over here are called as HTML forms. I hope you have understood this. Thank you. Thanks a lot.